Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how you can create dependent drop-down lists in Microsoft Excel using XLOOKUP. So what I mean by this is what I choose in this cell, if I go ahead and choose apples, then I'm going to get the apples list here because this is dependent upon here. And when I choose something here, this reflects because this was dependent upon this one. And it's using all this information on the sheet, and I'm not using any filtered list to do this. The other thing with this method, you can take this, copy them down, and these are all independent from each other. So if I choose down here, bananas, I'm gonna get the bananas list and everything will reflect. So let me show you how you can create these dependent drop-down lists using XLOOKUP in Microsoft Excel. So I find using the XLOOKUP function much easier than the previous method that I showed you using the indirect function. The one thing about XLOOKUP, this is going to be with Microsoft 365 subscription on it. So if you don't have that, take a look at my other video using the indirect function. All right. And the other thing I just wanted to mention, that this sheet that I'm practicing on here today, I'll put the link down below and then you can just save a copy to your computer and follow along as I create this using XLOOKUP. So the first thing I'm going to do is start with data validation to get my first drop-down list. And my first drop-down list is just going to be based upon these four fruit right here. So in this spot, I have A6 selected. I'm going to go up to make sure you're under data and then look for data validation, and I'm selecting it right here. So at this point, I need to drop down here and choose list. And this is very simple. All I need to do is I'm going to select my source, hit that, and just pick what my source is going to be. It's going to be these four fruit, and I'm just going to hit enter and okay. And look at this. I have my first drop down just like that. So when I choose bananas, I want the type when I do my next drop down, this list to be dependent upon this, what I choose. So I should see the four banana types. Okay, so this is where I need to start using my XLOOKUP function. And I know I said I wasn't going to do a filtered list, and I'm going to show you the way I did it at the beginning without a filtered list, but I just want to show you a filtered list to show you how XLOOKUP is working. And I'm just going to show you over here in this spot. Now, if I put equals in, I can start a function just like this, and I can look up XLOOKUP just like this. The other way, and I'm going to choose this one, the other way I could have done is hit this and look it up. I'm going to open this right up here because this can help with your arguments if you're new to this, to kind of go step by step. So what's my lookup value going to be? Well, it's going to look up whatever I choose here in A6. So I'm just going to select A6 and it goes into here. And then I'm going to go to lookup array. Well, what's it going to look up? Well, whatever I choose here, it's going to choose the array across here, just like that. And now I need the return array. Well, what's it going to return? Well, it's going to return everything, and I'll just move this down a bit. It's going to return everything here. I'm going to give a few extra spots in case you wanted to add it to some extra fruit after. And now I have what I need. I don't need to fill in these other two. So I'm just going to hit OK. And look at this. I have, since bananas are here, if I choose this to apples, and then I get the apples list. So this is this right here, this spot over here is dependent upon here. Notice it's putting some zeros in here. You can quickly get, I will show you how you can quickly get rid of those if you didn't want those in this list. If I click on the where Fuji is, because that's where the formula is actually in that spot. If I just go to the end here and I'm just gonna put, I'm gonna use the ampersand here, and I'm just going to put in a space just like this and watch, and I'll hit enter, and then whatever I choose, so if I choose my bananas, the zero is gone out of this. Now you could just do a validation, data validation just based on this spot. So what I mean is I could go here and click data and do a list again. What's my source going to be? Well, my source is actually this spot where the formula is, and I could hit enter. And I'm going to need to add something to the source. I'll show you in a second what I mean. So if I go to drop down, notice it's only showing one. So I'm going to go back to data validation up here and put a just a hashtag after it like this. And that way it allows me to do the list here. So just something if you're doing that way. So, and then this is working. If I choose bananas or oranges, And now I have my oranges list, just like that. Okay, so that's using a filtered list. This would be my filtered list. But if I wanted to copy down this, I'd have to have a new filtered list going for each one. I don't want that to have to happen. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna just create this first line using this method here. So in this last spot, I can use XLOOKUP again. So if I wanted to reflect, this is gonna be dependent on what I choose here, and it's gonna look at the amounts down here. If I hit equals, and I'm gonna just type in XLOOKUP just like this, and I'm gonna just go through the argument. So what is it gonna look up? Well, it's gonna look up whatever I choose in this spot, put a comma. What's the lookup array? Well, it's gonna look up the specific type of fruit here, and I put another comma, and then it's gonna look up the amount that I have left, the quantity. And then I can go ahead and just hit enter. Now I do wanna point out spelling matters, right? Because if I drop down and I go to Ladyfinger, notice I get an A here. Well, look at this, Ladyfinger here is spelled correctly, but it's missing the R over here. So if I add my R and go now, if I just drop down here for it, if I go back, now it will work. So just so you know, spelling does matter. So now I want to show you how you can do this without having the filtered list. And so we can copy some of this down and it will work. This right here, this first dropdown, I could just copy it down like this, and then it's going to be independent from this one when I choose up here. But this is the spot. Now I can go straight to data validation and then add my XLOOKUP formula into the source. So what I mean by this is if I go ahead and go up to data, then I'm gonna go data validation right here and I'm gonna choose my list. So I am gonna put in my formula using XLOOKUP. So just starting with my equal sign, I'm gonna be typing XLOOKUP just like that. And what were the steps? Well, the first thing is, what am I gonna be looking up? Well, it's gonna be look up this right here. And I'm gonna add a comma. Well, what's the array that it's pulling from? Well, it's gonna be pulling from this right here, comma. And what was the final step? It was gonna be this selection of where it's choosing from right here. So now at this point, that is XLOOKUP right inside this. So if I go ahead and hit okay, take a look at this. Right away, I have my dropdown list, just like this. And on this one, I could copy this down if I make a couple of changes. I'm gonna give it some absolute values in here by just hitting F4. So if I go ahead and hit function F4 on a few of these, because I don't want these to move. So you can go to your formula and just click inside of it. And I'm just doing function F4 to get those dollar signs around it just like that, hit enter. Doesn't look like anything changes, but what it allows me to do is copy it down now. So if I go back here, I'm gonna open up this data validation one more time and just open it up. You can see that the dollar sign is around the A7 too. Well, if I wanna be able to copy this down, I need to remove the dollar sign from the 7 here, because it's gonna be, if I copy it down, I want it to be able to go to the 8, but I can leave the dollar sign in front of the A, so just like this. Now, if I go and grab this and copy this down, take a look at this now. If I go and choose lemons and then drop down, I get all the lemons, and everything is dependent from these, and these are separate now just by putting the XLOOKUP in the data validation just like that. So I hope you like this tutorial on showing how you can do these dependent drop-down lists using XLOOKUP. I find this is the easiest way in Microsoft Excel if you do have this function inside your Microsoft Excel. Let me know if this works for you and if what other methods that you're looking for or other Microsoft Excel tips. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.